Πρόσφατα, στις 14 με 16 Μαρτίου, διοργανώθηκε από το Συμβούλιο της Ευρώπης στη Σεβίλη της Ισπανίας συνέδριο με θέμα υδάτινος παράγοντας και κοινωνία των ανθρώπων στα πλαίσια της κλιματικής αλλαγής και σε σχέση με την εφαρμογή της Σύμβασης του Τοπίου. Εγώ κλήθηκα να παρουσιάσω στην Ενότητα Διεθνής Εμπειρία την ανακοίνωσή μου με θέμα «Το νερό, πηγή υγείας, Παύλα, ο Πηνιός, ποταμός». Θα παρακολουθήσουμε ένα μικρό απόσπασμα της ανακτήριας ομιλίας της κυρίας Μαγγελόν Ντεζόν-Πον, Γενικής Γραμματέας Τοπίου.
Je vais parler en français parce que ma présentation est en français et dans le cadre de cette introduction sur les travaux du Conseil de l'Europe en matière de paysage et en matière d'eau, nous aborderons les travaux qui ont été faits dans le passé et qui continuent à se poursuivre au Conseil de l'Europe. Alors, le Conseil de l'Europe, vous le savez, est cette organisation intergouvernementale.
Παρουσιάζονται σε επεμβάσεις μεγάλης κλίμακας που γίνανε στα ευρωπαϊκά κράτη εν σχέση με τη σύμβαση τοπίου που συμμετείχα και καταλήγει εκφράζοντας τον ιδιαίτερο ενθουσιασμό της, όπως θα δούμε, με την παρουσίαση των επεμβάσεων ληπτικής τοπίου μεγάλης κλίμακας στο Άνιμος, ο πολιτισμός των θεσσαλικών πεδίων, χαρακτηρίζοντάς τες ως magnifique. Ένα γεγονός που μας συγκίνησε πολύ και τους Έλληνες αλλά και τους άλλους συνέδρους.
Exigences de la santé publique. Je me suis aperçue que de très nombreux projets concernaient l'eau et ils sont d'une très grande richesse et servent de modèle réellement pour des politiques publiques. Et vous avez ici un extrait des projets qui concernaient l'eau. Vous voyez, je ne vais pas lire tout cela, mais en voyant rapidement le parc de la Deule, des projets en Finlande, en Hongrie, au Royaume-Uni, avec les côtes, des projets extraordinaires en Finlande. J'ai que des superlatifs pour parler de ces projets parce qu'ils sont tous absolument magnifiques. En Serbie, je cite juste les pays, en Pologne, en Serbie, en Irlande, aux Pays-Bas, bien entendu, Portugal, Slovénie, Lettonie, Pays-Bas et Oslo, avec un projet extraordinaire qui a été présenté dernièrement en France, avec le paysage comme relation à Saint-Paul, à La Réunion, en République slovaque, avec des systèmes d'irrigation très sophistiqués dans les montagnes, avec le magnifique projet de Larissa en Grèce. Alors, je ne vais pas détailler chacun de ces projets parce que ce serait trop long, mais on n'en finit pas d'être émerveillé par la richesse de ces projets.
Thank you again, and I would like to express and to introduce our new presentator. This is Miss Neila Golanda from Greece. Very welcome and thank you for in advance.
Thank you. I would like to thank all the organization of this very important Congress about the water and our life. Magellan Desjardins, merci beaucoup. C'est un thème très, 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 très urgent et très, très frappant. Alors, je commence avec cette œuvre que j'avais faite en Thessalie. C'est une plaine au milieu de la Grèce, c'est un historique espace où les rivières Pignons, ils crossent toute la grandeur de cette. Alors, vous allez voir la vidéo. Je ne parle pas très bien. Alors.
Holistic total art interventions inspired by holistic healthcare services offered by the healing waters of the mythical river Pineios of Thessaly. Hydrotherapy in the cult of Asclepios, an ancient interactive relationship, osmosis, between the mythical, life-giving Pineios River and the anthropogenic, natural and historical landscape of Thessaly. Asclepios was the son of Apollo and Coronis. He was born in Thessaly. His father Apollo insinuated him in the art of medicine. He was worshipped in Thessaly and in the rest of Greece as a doctor and then as a god. in special healing temples, the Asclepiae. Apollo carried the baby Asclepios to the centaur Chiron, who raised him and insinuated him in the art of medicine on Mount Pelion. The centaurs lived in Thessaly, on Mount Pelion and Ossa, mountains rich in wild herbs. Chiron was known for his knowledge and skill with medicine, and this was credited with the discovery of botany and pharmacy, the science of herbs and medicine. So, Chiron taught Asclepios everything about medical use of herbs. The Asclepiae were healing temples dedicated to Asclepios, the first doctor god in Greek mythology. In fact, Asclepiae were the first hospitals conducive to healing. These temples belonged both to the Greek and Western civilization. In Asclepiae, besides Asclepios himself, both his mythological ancestors, Apollo and Artemis, were worshipped. Today, we know from written testimonies and archaeological findings that over 500 Asclepiae existed throughout ancient Greece. Asclepios and his two sons, these first mythical doctors, who collect the deep appreciation and recognition not only from Homer, but also from all the Greeks of that time, seem to be the founders of the great family of Asclepiades, descendants of Asclepios, the first hero doctor. He inherited the secrets of the art of medicine from generation to generation, and altogether offered their medical services to our mythological and historical antiquity in his name. We can include two great teachers among the Asclepiades, Hippocrates and Aristotle. The antiquities excavated at the east exit of the valley have revealed an ancient temple along with a Byzantine one, which proved to us that there was a diachronic pilgrimage dedicated to Cybele and Artemis, who were also deities of nature, strongly related to the Valley of Tempe. Artemis was the sister of Apollo. For the ancient world, the Valley of Tempe was a holy place with a purification and healing character due to the specific, important, rare, and precious qualities of the great waters. Thessaly is known for its many Asclepiae. The name of the neighboring city was Goni, where there was a statue of Asclepios in the museum. Asclepios also exists in Cranona, but it hasn't been excavated yet.
All around in the Thessaly, in this map, we can see the Neolithic place of the culture of...
Last year, I was invited to make a proposal for Animus, a holistic healthcare service complex located in the middle of the Thessalian Valley. It is one of the most imposing landscapes in Greece, with particular natural beauty, constituting a widely known reference point from a mythological and historical aspect. On the one side of the valley, Mount Olympus, the emblematic mountain, dominates the landscape, and on the other side, Ossa stands out, and in the middle flows the river Pineios, crossing and ending up in the Aegean. The first part of this intervention refers to the Neolithic everyday life symbols from the incredibly numerous Neolithic archaeological theses all over the Thessalian Valley, 7,000 to 3,500 BC. And the second one, the healing waters of the Pineios River as a source of health.
Here I would like to speak about the beauty of these symbols are the symbols of everyday use, of about to buy things. Its measures are containers that show what happened, the water, the liquid. There is a synchronization of very, very with a big beauty. It's something fantastic. Here we can see a theater. It's so old, these things. Here is an insect. Also, it's the beginning of some construction houses. And the spiral also. And here up, we can see the human that give the pleasure of living, if you like, is something fantastic. Also, this is a Neolithic symbol also about the hextags, about the measures. Is something that it's very, very, very emotional. You can imagine all this place around to live, to is all these theses that I show you is Neolithic theses in Thessaly, is all around, and has a very big force, a very big force of life, a force of the continuum of life till now. All the insects, all this beauty. I would like to thank because I have the chance to the pleasure to make this video for me. First of all, I can see these things, these symbols. I like very much the symbols, and we can imagine the life in Thessaly. The diachronic way of living, the history that comes till now in the patient person that are living there and make a big effort for survive, and in this surrounding, I would like to help them to feel that is in a person in a big line of person of people that are living in this place. They are trying to make their lives. Here it's the installation that they make with in this center with is the culture of the Thessalian landscapes is the name, and it's a way to show this in everyday movement of these persons in relation with the water that are using very much there, and and also I pass the marbles, and also this is the one side, and the other is another intervention that is going to finish. It's this second part with the waters with the Neolithic symbols of the water of Asclepion, if you like, that comes again to inspire their life.
My landscape intervention proposal was to focus on the culture of Thessalian landscapes by enhancing the daily effort to resuscitate patients and revitalize their mental health by engaging the power of the flow of historical time in relation to human existence.
Person that lays hello, I would like to thank you with the same honor. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Golanda, for this really interesting presentation. We may see that water has been a great provider, not only in physical terms, but also in the many ways it has contributed to the both natural and human-made environments through its aesthetic quality.
Is anybody want to say something? Oh yes, I can't see from here, but perhaps a colleague with microphone.
J'ai une question pour Monsieur Moret. Je suis Laurent Miguet, journaliste français à Paysage Actualité. Quand vous avez présenté l'approche intégrée des rivières de Wallonie. Vous avez... Thank you.